Hi, Ashley Kareem, British boxers. We're in Liverpool. I've got Nathan Bennett with me. Nathan, I just thought I'd catch up with you, mate.
How are we?
I'm all right, mate. Your last fight was a war.
Yeah, it was a good fight, wasn't it?
I watched it on the VIP show. Yeah. Talk us through it, mate.
Yeah, it was a good fight. It was. I thought I won the fight, not being biased or nothing, but I thought I won the fight. I thought I won the first three. I thought he gave him the fourth and the fifth, and I thought I won the sixth, and he gave it to him by a point, but it is what it is. It didn't discredit me. I thought it was a good fight, and
didn't
for me, fight.
All, no, it was
a fight that I didn't have to take. I asked for it because he'd come off a good winning streak. He's fighting him, Lee Appleyard, next week for the English title eliminator, so it shows where you're at, you know what I mean? So, it was a good fight.
I saw you were taking that fight, I thought, that's a dangerous one, because he was on a rich vein of form, yeah. Do you know what I mean? And as we just chatted there, his work rate is quite...
It's just non-stop, yeah. He just didn't give me a break. When normally when I'm fighting, you can throw your shots and then come off and have time to think. He just didn't give me time to think. He was just on me and on me and on me from the first bell. So, I've been doing strength conditioning now in Phoenix with my strength conditioning coach Charles after that fight, because I need it, just the power in Jordan's, because that's what it caused a lot in the fight. So,
do you feel like you've learnt more in that fight than you have in your previous sort of...
Yeah, in every in my other fights, I've learnt more in that old fight than what I've learnt in my other fights.
What will you take from it?
It's given me loads of confidence, you know, just to show that I can mix it when someone's coming at me like that. Because I know I'm not going to get another fight like that. Well, I will, but fighters you're fighting, they box, don't they? You know what I mean? They box a bit more than me. He's just non-stop on you. So giving me a bit more time to think and show me fitness in there, because no one's done that. Just matched them. I matched them in every way on the 6 rounds, you know.
Well, actually, the commentators were saying whilst it was going on that you were actually doing better than most other people.
Than the best. But the only fights he's lost, if you look at it, are only 4-round fights.
Yeah.
You know, if you fight him in a 6-round fight, he wins the fight.
Well, you know, he had upsets under his belt before he fought you, hadn't he?
Yeah.
Fleming and
Kane Gardner, yeah. And Kane Gardner's fighting for the Central area, so I'm looking on the winner of him and that Raymond.
Yeah. So basically, your motto at the minute is it's just a little blip in the road and you're going to carry on.
Definitely, yeah. I'm fighting on the 8th of December on the Scouts Jolly Boys top on that 6 rounder. And then I'm looking on the winner of the Gardner Raymond.
Yeah.
Definitely for the Central area.
Fair play. And somewhere down the line, would you like to have that rematch?
Definitely, yeah. I said to him, Steve Wood, I said it's after the rematch, but it's got to be for something, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Definitely.
How do you rate Ben's chances of beating him?
I think he beats Lee Appleyard.
Right.
Yeah, I think he beats him. I just think he's just be too much and too strong for him.
There you have it then, the title will be on the line.
Definitely, yeah. top it at the Olympia.
You might have to go down to Birmingham to fight him.
Defo, mate, I'll go anywhere to fight him.
No, but it's good to hear that you're still in good spirits.
Oh, yeah, thanks, Ab.
So just to recap, that's the Scouse Jolly Boys.
Let's go, 8th of December.
8th of December,
yeah.
And people can tune into that on the VIP stream.
Yeah,
perfect. Right, Nathan, listen, mate, I'll let you get back on and enjoy the show.
Thank you, Ab. Appreciate it.